Hey there, folks. Today we're going to be quickly talking about how we go about staking a claim in the New World. The first thing to know is that New World contains three separate factions we can become a part of: the Marauders, a more militaristic group of people, the Covenant, more religious based, and the Syndicate, who focuses on science and research. We can choose our factions really early in the game after completing some starting quest lines, and then we can join a company in New World that gets capped at 100 players. These companies act as guilds for this MMO, and the highest rank of these companies is known as the Governor. If someone creates a company within one of these factions, like Syndicate for example, they become Governor and you can join them. Only if you decide to join Syndicate as well. The second rank below Governor would be the Consul, which is like an officer rank, and there's multiple different permissions you gain access to depending on your rank, like access to the treasury, managing army rosters in the territory wars, and even getting access to the Consul chat if you are that rank. And this should be separate from the regular company chat too. We also have the mechanic known as the Siege Window function, and this comes into play if your company owns a territory, which allows you to set when your claims protection will go down. And this leads us into the territory aspect, starting with the war. So the way that war is declared between factions is that you have to conduct PvP-based faction missions to gain influence within a territory. You can capture the open world fortresses for your faction, and this will give you various different bonuses depending on which territory fort you claim. And it also gives you an influence bonus to speed up the declaring process in that zone. Once the bar has completely filled with influence gained from your faction, the territory will go into conflict mode. At this point, the faction that put the territory into conflict can declare war, but previously it was made to where if your company has contributed at least 10% of the total influence required to enter conflict mode, that is when you are eligible to declare war. In the unlikely event that no company has contributed at least 10%, then any company should qualify. But if multiple companies are able to declare war on the same territory during the conflict, the amount of influence a company contributed towards the conflict status will increase its chances of becoming the Vanguard. The Vanguard can then choose the army roster and lead the assault, and they gain the territory if the battle is won. Now, you can't sign up or fight against your own faction, but you can act as a third party if the leading company were to accept you. So if Covenant and Marauder are fighting with each other, Syndicate can join in on either side, and vice versa. You also need to spend money to engage in the declaring process, and this includes the purchase of your war camp. Then comes the territory war battle itself, which is the 50v50 mode that consists of 3 capture points, and the objective of capturing the territory fortress itself. After the battle, we come to the settlement management and governing process. The first thing to know is that if no company of any faction currently owns the territory, you can spend 100,000 gold at the fortress to become the first owner. But if you win it through warfare, then the same settlement process after will kick in. There's both company and faction benefits for owning a territory, such as the resource supply carts, housing and fast travel discounts, etc. Each territory has its own localized market and storage system, but also taxes do play a part. The governing company can set housing tax for players that own homes, refining tax for resource benches, crafting tax for crafting items, and a trading tax for the trading post auction house. This tax comes in the form of gold to the governing company's treasury, and this can then be used towards various different things, including upgrading the settlement benches through town projects, upgrading the fort defenses for wars and invasions, and assigning lifestyle buffs. Setting up any of these objectives will create what is known as town projects. This is a community-based way of progressing through a settlement, and we normally need to do crafting and gathering related missions to complete this. Now, the lifestyle buffs do become available for people that are residents in a territory. You need to first level up your territory standing level, which is based on the zone you're in, and then after about level 10 and in different stages after that, you're able to purchase a house. So some houses may require a higher level territory standing and be more expensive, but these are normally the more luxurious and spacious housing choices. You also get a discount for your first time purchasing a house, so this is another thing that's important to keep in mind. There's different things that you can do with the house, such as placing down house trophies that can be obtained and crafted. These will offer different bonuses to your characters, such as crafting bonuses, luck bonuses, and even gathering and combat related ones. You can place down storage chests inside your house to increase the capacity of your local bank in that zone, place down a vast array of cosmetic furniture that also includes housing pets you can interact with, and you can also get access to a fast travel teleport by owning a house that helps you cover long distances if you need to recall. You can own up to a total of 3 houses, one can be bought at level 20, one at level 40, and the last at level 60. And you can have these spread out across different zones. And that's the basics you need to know when it comes to staking a claim in New World. Thanks so much for watching, and farewell.